Welcome back to Sister Circle Live, whether spitting a hot 16 or acting in Fox hit drama Empire or starring in the hit small screen films like Down for Whatever, Bre-Z is making her mark in music and in Hollywood.
And now she's starring in a new television series on the CW. It's called All American. Let's take a look at it.
How come you ain't bring your girl?
No.
Yeah, you do.
Well, you think because you moved to Beverly Hills, you know everything?
Nah, I'm just saying, all right? You like her. We both know why you're holding back. You and me, we gotta stop worrying about the parents who rejected us, man.
All right. Yes. Everybody, please help us in welcoming Bre-Z.
Yes!
Doing it.
Wow.
You better come on out here and sit on down. Enjoy your sisters.
Yeah.
Listen, you know we're proud of you, right?
Mm-hmm.
You are doing it all. Every time I turn on the TV, there's one face that I always see. It's yours.
Yeah. Yes,
it's yours. I've had an opportunity to see you in All American. Of course, Empire, you did your thing. Mm-hmm. We was a little mad. You raised your pistol up on our boy. But
you know, I was doing my job.
We're going to get through it. We still kind of cool.
Yeah.
Okay? But I want to know, how do you really manage not to neglect any of your talents? I mean, you're doing music, you're acting, you're everywhere. How do you do that?
I honestly just do what I want to do. I do what's on my heart at all times. So I'm not, none of my life is scripted. I do what feels right to me.
Mm-hmm.
So my music is like my outlet. It's my diary. So when I get home at night and there's things I won't say or things I haven't talked about, that's where I let that out at.
Yeah.
You know, and when I do my work on television, that's my job.
Yeah.
You know, fortunately, so I do that while I'm there.
And yeah.
I do everything I can though.
Yeah, good.
Yeah. Well, before you started All American, of course, we all know you well on Empire.
Yes.
So how did your role on Empire prepare you for your role in All American, as Tiana?
Honestly, that was my entry to television and film. And for me, it was just, I learned a lot from Terrence and Taraji, just how to handle the business.
Yeah.
I don't think it was about the job, it was about the business.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so just getting acclimated with that scene and, you know, being on time and your directors and your writers and just, you know, just a certain level of respect and that I have anyway, because that's how I was raised.
That's
so, you know, just hearing, you know, their wisdom through their experience and, you know, that was really all I could ask for.
Yeah. Well, I got to go back to All American. I really do, because there was a scene that I watched and I was like, I cannot believe that this is happening.
Mm-hmm.
So your character is in love and has a special friend who's a woman.
Mm-hmm.
And your mother is deeply rooted within the church and also cares about what people think of her.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You came to her and you told her that it's not the lady, it's actually you that you are attracted to, to women.
Right.
How does that actually translate into your real life? And what have been some real life situations that you would want the audience to know with watching a scene like that?
I think for me, it's parents have no idea. For one, our show gives a bird's eye view on what your child may be going through once they leave your doors.
That's right.
When we get to high school, it's a totally different story. You see, parents don't get phone calls till the school's been shot up. You don't know what your kid is going through. And with that situation in particular, I want people to know what it's like to shut your child out.
Yeah,
you cannot shut people out, period.
That's
but
right.
especially your child.
That's
I mean,
right.
that is a love that should never be tarnished or tampered with. And the fact that, you know, we have showcased that this happens, you know, because of, you know, spirituality or, you know, political views or whatever, it happens, but this drives people to suicide, to depression.
Yes.
Talk about it. We're in a time right now where those things are as high as they ever been.
Mm-hmm.
So we will watch Coop take her road based off of being shut out, being denied by the one person that you have loved before you knew what that was.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I just really hope that for the people that are guiding this generation, that you help, that you extend your hand, just please, because it really is tearing. We're losing people, like,
yeah, we are.
You know, like, it's crazy. Yeah. So I'm glad that we were able to touch on that. And that's
I was mad about it.
Yeah.
And that scene
brought tears to my eyes when I recorded it, because I couldn't imagine, like, my mother, after she watches, she texts me, like, you know, I love you so much, and if you know, I apologize, or whatever. My mom, she never did anything, but you never know, because how many of us are vocal about you know, the ways that we feel. So I'm just happy that it was, you know, publicized.
Yes, that's good.
I am.
Well, speaking of being vocal, you have a new album coming out called Girl G-R-L.
Yes.
What happened to that? Yeah, why not the I?
I took the I out, honestly, because it's no I in what I do.
Okay, and yes.
I do what I do for... I do what I do for everybody, mm-hmm. every woman, every man, every soul that comes in contact with mine. So that's why I do it. And that's just it. So when I say the girl, it's all of us.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's just the selflessness in me. It's something simple, and I'm surprised you even caught on to it, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Because nobody's
ever
asked me about it.
Yeah. I actually saw you, if I'm not mistaken, you did a little bit of dappering in reality TV. Did I see you do something like that?
I did not. I was a barber.
Oh, okay.
I was a barber, so I've cut a lot of people's hair, which put me on.
How did you get your start in acting?
I was still just cutting hair and doing my music, and it happened to be an old client of mine who had a connection and reached out to me as in regards to the audition.
That's dope.
So you're singing, well, you're rapping, you got your acting, your Barbara, get your cut.
Yeah.
So what is it that you want to do that you haven't done yet?
I was just talking about this. I want to open a children's home.
That's amazing.
I want to open a barbershop, of course. And I just feel like everything I do is to give. So whatever I can do, I can't even tell you that, I want to have a big compound full of, I don't. Yeah. I don't need a lot, you know what I'm saying? But I do want to help as much as I can.
Oh, well, I appreciate you and just
your
honey. I love it. You're always welcome down to the circle. Of course, if you want to catch Bre-Z, honey, you can catch her on the hot new series, All American, every Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern on the CW.
And up next, guess what? We have Dr. Ron. He has some tips for surviving holidays with diabetes. Don't miss it. I dated a guy, he had liabetes.
What is